Hello and welcome to what I think will be the final episode on calculators. In earlier episodes, I've shown you the calculators from the 70s and an in-depth look at Hewlett-Packard calculators. In this episode, let's explore the 80s and I will show you the top 7 aspects to look for in calculators that make these calculators particularly collectible. Really at the turn point of 1979 to 1980, suddenly calculators began having LCD displays. The first LCD displays in calculators, you can recognize them because they are very yellowish or greenish, depends on how you look at it. That didn't take long. They improved that technology and also, yeah, vintage LCD calculators like these. Still a bit chunky, were created, and you can see they are still a bit thick. So what they also learned was that with the less power hungry LCD displays, they could move from these type of batteries to these type of batteries. So the button batteries also were part of the calculator revolution that made the calculators much thinner, of course. This led to a design that was called the credit card size calculators even. Especially the brands like Radio Shack and Canon and Sharp. But there are also some LCD calculators that I will show you now that are collectible for another reason. By far the most precious and collectible LCD calculators are those of Hewlett-Packard. With their reverse Polish notation, they really have a cult following. Check my episode number 71 for a full report. In the very early 80s, Hewlett-Packard, Casio and Sharp started to create basic programmable LCD pocket computers. Handheld computers, very small. Often only one line of LCD display, but still basic programmable. So yeah, that was a rather nice revolution. But the real marketing machine came from Tandy with their Radio Shack brand. Tandy had the TRS-80 personal computer, which was enormously popular. And what Tandy did was they rebranded some of the Casio and the Sharp models as being TRS-80 pocket computers.
Here's another Radio Shack major computer breakthrough. The amazing new TRS-80 pocket computer, only $249. Imagine a basic language computer that weighs just 6 ounces. Now carry TRS-80 power in your pocket while traveling, on the job, solve problems, process data, and store it in permanent memory for instant recall. The amazing TRS-80 pocket computer, only at Radio Shack, the biggest name in little computers.
So if you see TRS-80 pocket computers, they can either be Sharp or Casio. The Tandy PC-3 was a rebadge of the Sharp 1251 pocket computer, and it was created in 1982. The Casio FX-702 is a basic programmed pocket computer, even though it's still called a calculator on it. By Casio, it was introduced in 1981. The Casio PB100 was introduced in 1982 and already has the personal computer name on it. Also basic programmed, and this was also
sold by Tandy under the PC4, TRS-80 PC4 name.
So those pocket computers were revolutionary because of their functionality, of their the technology. What also makes for collectible calculators is design. These Brown calculators were famous for their design. They were designed by the world famous German industrial designer Dieter Rams.
One of the legacies of Dieter Rams is that his calculator design was an inspiration for Jonathan Ive from Apple when he created the calculator in iOS on the iPhone. As you can see, some slight variations were made of this calculator, and the one on the right has a world clock in it as well.
Some calculators were maybe not having like basic programming languages, alphanumeric keys, etc., but still introduced some nice technology that made them particularly wanted and still collectible. Casio, for example, created combinations of calculators with games, as did Texas Instruments with their Little Professor range. I'm going to show you those when I come to my Vintage Tech games collection. But this one I wanted to show you. This is a Casio calculator from the 80s that introduced music functionality. So I just wanted to show you. Let's see if I can still do this. As always, thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe. I see that still 2/3 of the people that watch these videos are not a subscriber. So please subscribe, and thank you very much for that. Stay safe. Calculator design that, okay. Version I have on, were designed by the famous industrial German designer. Dat is echt helemaal verkeerd. Ik wil zo'n texting hebben.
Ja. Het doesn't work.